Hey guys, GJC here to teach you all about competitive marbles racing and marbles on stream, and how to use it to get free pixel by pixel coins. Pixel by pixel coins, of course, are the in-game currency used to unlock customizations for the game. So marbles on its surface is pretty casual. A stream and a community can just use the races to interact and have a good time rolling. Fun fact about marbles, it was initially inspired to be used on stream for giveaways, and indeed to this day, it is still used by many streamers for that same reason. It is in that spirit that the studio holds regular community days, which leads me to my first tip about how to earn free pixel by pixel coins. Every Friday, the studio hosts community day starting at noon Eastern. Usually halfway through the community day, the studio will raid into one of the community managers' spew and standard damage. Pixel by pixel coins are awarded to winners of every race, but you can also choose to win an exclusive skin for you to use in your races if you're a streamer playing the game on Twitch. Community Day is always my first recommendation to anyone new to marbles. Not only is it a place you can win stuff, but it's also a place you get to learn about marbles from the whole community. Prizes are awarded to first place, but if there are over 200 marbles, then both first and second place get prizes, and for every additional 100 marbles, payouts will be given. Here's another tip about the Pixel by Pixel Twitch channel. You could redeem in-channel Streamelements points to purchase rewards in the stream store. One of the rewards is 100 pixel by pixel coins will be awarded to the winner of the next race. Overall, Community Day is a great place for you to meet everyone in the Marbles family as we get together to celebrate the end of the week. Most racers start out playing marbles pretty casually, but as you play more and more, you'll soon find out about competitive marbles racing. The heart of competitive marbles racing is the leaderboard. Here you'll find the names of all the top racers on the global leaderboards, as well as the top streamers during each marbles season. This is the score screen at the end of each race. Racers earn points toward the global leaderboard by having high finishes in qualified races. The more marbles a channel has, the more points are awarded to the racers. Streamers earn experience points towards the streamer leaderboard for each qualified race they run. Again, the more racers you have, the more XP you will earn. The length of the race also adds more points for both streamers and racers, but currently the cap is at 3-minute races. Any races longer than that will not earn extra experience points. Each race also has a minimum and must be at least 1 minute long in order to award points. Now we come to the most important part of competitive marbles. If the leaderboard is the heart of competitive marbles, then the energy system is the blood that fuels it. In order for racers to collect points toward the global leaderboard, they must have energy. Each race costs 1 energy point. The best way to check your energy is at the end of every race in the energy column. During a race, a streamer could focus in on an individual marble with the F key. Pressing the I key will toggle the player's profile, which will list how much energy a player has. Downloading the Marbles on Stream mobile app shows the energy of a racer on the home screen. It's also a fast way to create a marbles account to purchase customizations for your marble. You can even use it to check the global leaderboards. Although the marble races are based purely on RNG and winners are chosen random, that doesn't mean there isn't any skill involved in competitive marbles racing. The skill comes from managing the limited amount of energy your marble has each day. Starting at 3 a.m. Eastern, the energy system resets, giving each racer 50 energy. You will soon find out that doesn't last very long if you open up a bunch of marble streams and start dropping marbles in every channel. This is where the energy tier system comes in. Racers are awarded with a return of energy for racing multiple races in the same streams. The energy system is broken into multiple tiers. At tier 1, 5 total races, 5 energy is returned. Tier 2, 10 races, 6 energy. Tier 3, 20 races, 11 energy. Tier 4, 35 races, 16 energy. Tier 5, 55 races, 21 energy. Tier 6, 80 total races, 25 energy. Tier 7, 110 races, 30 energy returned. And Tier 8, 145 total races with a whopping 35 energy returned. Keep in mind, the races still stack as long as you race with the same streamer before the energy reset at 3 a.m. Eastern. So if you miss a race or two, you can still continue to work towards the next tier. Keep in mind that when you run out of energy, you will no longer be able to stack tiers of races. Often, competitive racers will need to stop racing in one stream just to finish off tiers in another stream so that they have enough energy to complete all their tiers. The bonus column in the score screen shows how far they've completed their tiers. Players who will complete their tiers are shown on the far right side, and it also shows how much energy they get returned. For streamers, it's very important to always show this part of the score screen. This leads me to my next tip for streamers, which is called quality options. Competitive racers are often in multiple streams at the same time, which eats up a lot of bandwidth. In order to limit their bandwidth and prevent lag from having too many streams open, they will often lower their bitrate of the streams using quality options. You can adjust quality options by clicking the cogwheel at the bottom of the browser. Now, partner streamers on Twitch will always have quality options, but for affiliate streamers, that's not always the case. And even worse, for non-affiliates, it's incredibly rare to get quality options. You can always check to see if you have it by opening a browser before you start stream. Once you go live, verify it by checking the cogwheel. Now, if you don't have quality options, you can always restart your stream until you do get it. But be aware this may take several tries. The top 200 globally ranked players have their numbers listed next to their names. In addition, there's a legacy system for racers with high finishes at the end of the season. The top 30 racers at the end of the season will receive points toward their legacy badge or gemrods. The higher the finish, the more points that are awarded to the badge. As the upgrades continue, the gemrods become more and more impressive looking, as well as changing colors. The top 10 streamers at the end of each marble season is invited into a special tournament, the winner getting to put an emote into the game. Subscribers who own the emote will be able to use that to spawn the streamer's custom marble in all the races on Twitch playing marbles on stream.
Streamer XP is used towards streamer challenges to help unlock free pixel by pixel coins as well as exclusive skins. After each race, at the score screen, a streamer can see how much XP they have earned for that race. You may also notice that there is a section next to it listing the number of bonus races. This is the number of races a streamer has that counts towards double experience points. You only get bonus races back when not streaming. One bonus race is awarded for each rested hour, with a cap at 120 races. Streamers also earn extra bonus points by helping racers complete their energy tiers. At Tier 1, 5 races, a streamer earns one extra bonus point. At Tier 2, they earn two extra bonus points. Tier 3, three extra bonus points, and so forth. Finally, we come to my favorite part of competitive marbles, and that is tournaments. Streamers are able to host official marble tournaments by purchasing kits from the studio. The kits award first place, an exclusive cosmetic that can be equipped through the Marbles app. The top 15 finishers of the tournament also receive pixel by pixel coins. This is another way for racers to earn free pixel by pixel coins by participating in these tournaments and finishing in the top 15. Tournament points are set up using the local leaderboards. There you can choose how many points are awarded for each place in a race. This is a lot of fun to use because you can use these for non-official marble tournaments. For example, I use them for my pizza tournament. After every 50 subs I get to my Twitch channel, I host a pizza tournament. The winner of the tournament gets sent Chicago Deep Dish Pizza in the mail. If you would like to purchase a tournament kit or just want to learn more about them, make sure to join the Pixel by Pixel Discord. Now, there are two special tournaments held each season by the studio, usually hosted by Pixel or the community managers Spoo and Standard Damage. These tournaments are the mid-season and end-of-season tournament. If community days are like get-togethers for the Marbles family, then these tournaments are like our big family reunion. These special events are co-hosted by streamers from the community along with the studio members. It's a real honor to be asked to co-host, and it was the highlight of my streaming career. The top 20 racers get a choice of winning pixel by pixel coins, exclusive modifiers, or a choice of skins. As a bonus, I wanted to explain how the other playing modes of marbles affect energy and experience. You may have noticed the other modes outside of standard are called Battle Royale and Tilted. Battle Royale marbles face off and only one marble survives to win. It's a fun change of pace mode that allows racers to target each other in battle. Royale energy and experience points work pretty much similar to the standard races, each Royale costing one energy. Tilt mode is an obstacle course where the streamer tilts the board trying to maneuver marbles to the goal at the end of the board. Tilt mode is very interesting though, when it comes to energy and experience. Tilt mode does not cost any energy for the racer, but the racer still earns points towards the global leaderboard just by participating. This is extremely useful if a racer is short or out of energy for the day. On the streamer side, tilted races don't cost any bonus races and is a good way to earn experience points.
Congratulations, now you've learned all you need to know about competitive marble racing and how to earn free pixel by pixel coins. Before we end, I want to say something about pixel by pixel coins. They actually support the studio directly. Unlike most game studios, Pixel by Pixel is 100% funded and sponsored by the community. There are no outside investors. So by purchasing Pixel by Pixel coins and subscribing to the studio Twitch channel, you are actually directly helping make this game that we all love. I have included all the relevant links in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, please like this and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will certainly be putting out more Marble videos. Also, please follow me on Twitch and feel free to drop into stream whenever I'm live to ask any questions about Marbles. I really do enjoy teaching people about the game. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the races.